1.
Electric start. Takes less time on average to recover from a backhand, so Wang Yidi is definitely going to be pressuring the crossover section and the forehand of Polkanova in this match.
Oh, no. No.
What an angle there. To finish things off in flamboyant style. Wow. Not easy to hit a winner past a player of Polkanova's reach.
1-2.
Good third ball spin there from the Austrian. Gets her first point.
3-1.
Wang Yidi definitely the favorite here, Ida.
Yeah. I think Wang is playing more to the middle of Sofia, keeping in mind her strong backhand.
Yes.
Still haven't seen any backhand from Sofia.
3-2.
She's got a wristy backhand.
And always safe, always on the table.
Yeah. Especially, I feel like, on the third ball. And against pushers, Polkanova is very consistent with that shot.
Three,
four. It's good also this deep push as a receive, you know. So Wang is always waiting that maybe the person in front of her, like, just flick the ball. And it's a smart strategy also from Sofia sometimes to deeply push it.
Incredible shot tolerance there from Polkanova against one of the hardest hitters in the world. What do you think is a good tactic, Ida, from being a professional yourself, to beat top Chinese players like Wang Yidi? What would you be looking for as like the base level tactic?
I would look always to make them defense more, not attack, definitely. Yeah.
You don't want to bait them into that.
No.
How do you get a Chinese defensive?
To be more, I think, like work more with their service so that you force them that they be more passive.
So you have to go out and out attack, you feel?
Four,
you see, like,
five.
When Sofia starts, it's more the point is going to her. More short walls, and she's starting the point by herself.
Well, she's taking the lead here, the Austrian. 4-5. Wow.
6-4.
Changing the rhythm also. Like you see, like she played more with top spin till the middle and then really fast in the deep forehand. I think most of the Chinese players are very good when it is just like fast balls. And they struggle a little bit when you change the rhythm.
I agree with that completely.
4.
She's on cloud 9 here, Polkanova. This is some of the best I've seen her play in a long time. We know she's had injuries with that right knee. Being a tall player, you see that because you've got to get so low in table tennis. On average, you know, world champions aren't that tall. Tries
five,
a bit of a strawberry seven. Flick there, Polkanova. She's definitely confident. You were telling me, Ida, your favourite player ever is Vladimir Samsonov.
Yeah.
Taller players, where do they want to be stood? Because you don't want to be too close as a tall player, do you?
Exactly. They need to take a step further from the table and just wait a little bit for the ball and take it in the right timing from outside the table.
Why do you feel that is?
They definitely, I think, like, whenever they take this step outside the table, they have, like, a better eye on the ball, you know, and they can easily read the ball where it is going and be there.
Yeah, I see. Needs to make a move now, Wang Yidi.
9.
Polkanova looking good here. I think another thing about tall players is they have that big crossover section. You know, bigger mid-region to hit into, it's harder to protect. So if she wants more time, to recover and make space for that. She wants to be a bit further back, and she's doing well here, the Austrian.
10-5.
Five game points. Not many people saw this coming. You need to shock and awe the Chinese. And she's done just that. Cho Yike cannot believe it.
6-10.
It's so strange that Wang is always pushing long in the middle. You know, she didn't change one time to push long in the backhand or even deep in the forehand. You feel like Sofia is always waiting for the long bush in the middle and doing it really, really well.
Mm. You need more unpredictability from Wang Yide.
7-10.
She needs to take more risk. The form that Polkanova is in at the moment. The biggest risk she can take is just trying to play too safe.
So safe, yeah.
10, lovely.
8.
Gorgeous third ball fade there.
The serve was so good with topspin, and yeah, that makes it easier with the push.
Yeah. Couldn't identify it there, Polkanova. Maybe she could, but it was so low and tight. Couldn't do much more about it.
I would take the risk now, you know, if I were Sofia and play just a long serve deep on the backhand.
Okay, let's see what she does.
Yeah!
Well,
long, but 11, in the forehand.
Yeah, into the forehand. Reverse pendulum serve now.
One,
it's a bit of fortune.
Low.
That spin was great. You feel like the angle of the ball was, or angle of her racket was very good with the ball, like closing it.
That was more of a flat hit, wasn't it? The way she came into that. Brilliant shot.
1-2.
Again, but this mistake happened because there were more spin in Wang's serves.
Mm.
Although it was actually the same style from Sofia.
It's opposites in many ways. The more spin, the more you've got to counteract it with a closed racket angle. The more backspin, the more you have to lift it with a more open racket angle. It's all about how you meet the ball. And that depends on what kind of ball you're getting.
3,
Wang Yide
2.
Is extremely explosive. She's like a barrel of acid. She's so compact as well. So she can play a big shot, Wang Yide, and then get in position basically straight away for another one if needed. And look at that buggery for that block.
It was a smart strategy from Sofia, but Wang was ready for it.
Mm. Sends it to the open space. Polkanova played an all cards on the table forehand there. Left the wide forehand exposed. Wang was so composed in reading it and playing that space. Seemingly effortlessly, but that's a very difficult shot to do.
3-4.
Just for context, this would undoubtedly be the win of Sofia Polkanova's career. She hasn't beaten a top five Chinese before.
Five,
on
three.
The run there, making a transition from a forehand to a backhand and playing the parallel. That is so hard to do.
She's taking the perfect space outside of the table. Like, you feel like as if Wang balls are not strong enough for her.
Yeah.
Five, four.
Well, she's lost to a couple of Japanese players, Hayata, in two massive matches. The Asian Games semi, but before that, the match of the World Championships and the quarterfinal to Hayata again. She lost to Kahara in Lanzhou. Not having the best time of it this season, really, in some big matches, Wang Yide. But to lose to a European would be a whole new thing, wouldn't it? Different kettle of fish. Doesn't want to make that happen.
6-5.
It's a better serve there. Caressing the ball with that pendulum. I think he had a bit of backspin on it.
Yeah, Wang is trying to like close the play more by playing more underspin point.
5-7.
Managed to catch Sofia Polkanova in the crossover there.
Because even if you flick like an underspin serve, somehow you are slow with the ball afterwards.
Because it takes so much effort against the backspin, you're then not quick enough out.
Exactly, to recover after this ball.
That's a very, very insightful point you make there.
Five, eight.
Well, this is a kill streak here from Wang Yidi.
Wow.
9-5.
That's a joke.
She's laughing.
Yeah, and it's better to laugh than cry, isn't it, sometimes? Could taste it on the tip of her tongue there, Polkanova, but still couldn't get it.
9-6.
Nine, six to the Chinese player.
Six,
it's a great
ten.
Combination. She baits Polkanova in, who plays the backhand from the forehand side, and then she can't recover. Wang puts it even wider into the forehand. 4 game points.
7-10.
Sofia still fighting for every point.
Eleven, seven.
Tries the strawberry game again. She hasn't really had much success with it. Wang Yidi beginning game number 3.
1-0.
What do you think might have changed here, Ida, to make this match 1-1 now? Did you notice anything from that previous game?
Wang Yidi make it more with starting more with underspin and forcing Sofia more to be like not flicking a lot of points. You know, like you see here, like she pushes it.
Love. Yeah.
You know, she's not giving her game easily. And also, Wang Yidi is so smart with the placement of her top spins.
She's playing it always away from the racket of Polkanova. Pinning the middle, amazing
love
recovery, but
three.
Still not enough. Too late for a timeout at this moment, or would you save it for the next game?
I would save it for next game.
Might just be delaying the inevitable. She's 4 points down. Might not have been a bad shout to call it earlier.
Five.
Maybe after losing the first 2 points. It is snowballing out of control here for the European champion.
One, 5.
Sofia is very known with her calm attitude and strategic, like, playing.
Yeah.
So you don't, like, think, like, okay, it's 5-1, then she's losing the game. No, she normally recover again and come back to the game. I would say she's still having the hope that she will do so in this game, too.
Let 1-5.
We know she's capable of a comeback, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Got the serves here to help her cause.
1-6.
It's not a great serve, to be honest, and it put her on the back foot there.
Six,
it's better.
2.
She's got a very good reverse pendulum. Look at the wrist action there. contacting it closer to the edge of the racket to produce more spin.
Van Gies is brilliant.
It. 12 of the last 16 points to Wang Yidi.
Two, eight. Two, nine.
Although the backhand serve give her better positioning after it, but still not strong enough to win the point with her backhand spin afterwards.
It's a tactical change, but it's come too late.
Ten, two.
Why at 8-2 would you change, you know? That's desperation for me.
But maybe just trying new things that you just tested for next set. It also might be a
true,
good idea
could,
for
yeah.
that.
Test the waters a little bit, perhaps.
Exactly.
That's a fair point. 8 game points.
10-3.
Just too strong, Wang Yidi. It's a cracking rally.
Love what?
Mind-blowing pace. Falls to one knee there. It is a point that you would propose to. 23 of the last 32 to Wang Yidi. I'll say this about this performance. It's already an improvement from their last and only encounter. It was 4-0 to Wang Yidi back in 2020 at the ITTF Finals in Zhangzhou.
Two,
how many times is she going to toast Polkanova over there?
Seems like she's even talking to herself, like, why are you playing in the backhand and she's waiting there?
She'd be better off going down the middle.
Yeah.
Because then it makes it less obvious for Wang Yidi to switch wide.
Yes.
Two,
wow, look at
four.
That. A bit of fortune, but still, it's a very good one.
Yeah. It favoured the brave, didn't it, there?
They need to go more with underspin services to make the pace slow of the game.
Three,
you see, like, okay, now again, like net, but it's still.
It's better tactics, you can see that. She's not inviting the open play, 100%. Hasn't gone for the backhand serve since she tried it.
No, it wasn't underspin. No.
Three, all.
And now the half long make it more tough for Sofia. People might see half-long as if it is an easy ball, but it is actually not easy at all.
Why is that?
You need to wait and change your timing and have a good spin in the ball until you make it right. And sometimes it's not easy, the change in the game.
Three,
it's that
four.
Kind of indecision, isn't it? It's like kind of tricky to play that ball with that back edge there.
And it's also to read it. Was it short or it is actually really half long?
Makes you indecisive.
Mm-hmm.
It can help get an easier ball, can it, in the next ball if it comes back.
Five,
well, this is
three.
Brilliant. Eight. Stabilizing the elbow and it's coming through the forearm, isn't it? Like an anchor. Short and sharp. Sofia Polkanova, two ahead with the serves.
Five,
this
four.
This unforced error is so costly for Sofia now.
What was wrong with that flick? Why did she miss that?
The bush was actually with no spin, and she gave it a lot of spin that wasn't needed.
She could have gone more direct.
Yeah.
And she was a little bit upright, wasn't she? Her head wasn't low enough.
Five, all.
Well, Wang Yidi needs a net, and I think she deserves one because Polkunova's had a couple, hasn't she?
Yeah, I agree. The crowd is for Sofia, of course.
Yeah. Not so far from Germany, is it? Austria.
Six, five.
And a timeout.
6-0.
A fortunate point for Sofia.
Crowd here just trying to get together, do their bit. She's got the aura ring there on her forefinger to track her sleep.
6-7.
But again, the flick. She's too upright on it.
But it was right tactic that she wanted to start a parallel ball because she was always doing it cross.
Yeah. 100%.
And now an underspin serve.
She doesn't like that one, Wang Yidi, that reverse pendulum with backspin. Seven all, business time.
Eight, seven. Nine.
Well, I don't think she's made one. And she went for it there for the surprise factor. She's not a player that you associate as a player of feeling and flair as such, Polkunova.
7-10.
And it's three match points to Wang Yidi. Looking to wrap this up in four-game fashion. She's on the receive.
11.
Strong
seven.
Finish.
Game and match.
Really not a lot in it between those two in that encounter.